Hello. In this video, we'll examine how to add plugins like Graph Data Science to a Neo4j instance. Currently, I have a Neo4j instance running on Google Kubernetes Engine. Although your setup might differ, the principles for managing plugins are largely the same. Now I'll log into the instance to demonstrate that we have a standard Neo4j setup. Once connected, we'll add some sample data to work with by clicking on the Try Neo4j with Live Data card and running an associated code block. If we try to create a graph projection at this point, we will receive an error stating that GDS procedure is unavailable since we don't yet have that plugin set up. To resolve this, let's demonstrate how to add the GDS plugin to your Neo4j instance with a Kubernetes-focused but portable approach. First, ensure your plugins directory is persistent. For example, we're adding a persistent volume claim to the Neo4j installation and then adding associated Helm values to utilize that volume. Next, use the additional volumes and additional volume mounts from the official Helm chart to mount the plugins folder inside the Neo4j installation directory. Add two configuration values to enable the GDS procedures. You can do this either through Helm values or a neo4j.conf file. To automatically add the GDS plugin to the plugin volume, you can use init containers within the pod spec portion of the Helm chart. This will download and unzip the GDS plugin into the plugin directory. We recommend creating your own Docker image for this init container, but you can use the Docker image that we've published for experimentation. We'll mirror the Neo4j user setup in the init container to simplify permissions. Note that the init container will run every time the pod boots up or restarts. Although this slows down the process slightly, it should not add more than a few seconds. Ensure that the resource requests and resource limits for the init container are equal to or less than those of the Neo4j main container. Also, keep in mind that the version 2.3.1 GDS plugin requires Neo4j version 5.5.0 or earlier, so you may need to use an older version than the latest in the official Helm chart. After updating your Helm chart, check the logs for the Get Plugins container, which should download and unzip the GDS plugin. Once the main container starts up, refresh the page and reconnect to your database. You can verify the correct installation of the GDS plugin by attempting to create a graph projection again. This time, the process should be successful. Hooray! Yay! Regardless of whether you're using Kubernetes, just keep in mind the three-step process. Place the plugin jar file in the plugins directory, add the necessary configuration values, and restart the Neo4j system. With that, you should be all set to use GDS or other plugins with your Neo4j instance. We hope this video was helpful, and we'll keep an eye on the comments section for any questions. Thank you for watching.